Welcome back, MechWarriors. This is Opa Plays MechWarrior 5. And we're back in the same place we were, doing the same thing we were talking about. I went ahead and upgraded the mediums and larges and a couple of SRM6s and consolidated, and that's what we have now. I'm not going to take away four large laser 3s or 2s to give me 1-3. Already got enough. Same thing with the tier 4s, got a couple, and we're gonna roll from here. Everybody's already being repaired. My work orders are still got 35 days on the battle master, so may or may not see him in this episode. Gonna be two more missions, one over here in Bethel, finishing off that's part 3 of the conspirators. We'll go ahead and get that one. I think this one's a demo. Pretty much right in line with what the Orion's built to do. Campaign 310. Gonna do a preemptive strike against a nearby garrison. Yep. Smells like a demolition. Tad bit of salvage just in case we get lucky. 4 million. Money's starting to pile up.
Weather conditions in the area will restrict visibility and have an effect on your sensors.
Still got 6 day wait on the Orion. It did get beat up pretty heavily. That's why I switched off to the pretty baby. Oops. That was my keyboard sliding. Not what you think. Had to move it out of the way because the dog absolutely insisted upon standing on my desk and getting some attention between episodes. He's pretty much literally twice or half my weight, so you don't ignore him. Twice my weight would have been something. Here we are.
This will be an assault against a regional military base manned by the Certis Fusiliers. Preemptively attacking this FRB ensures that the Fusiliers won't be able to mount an attack against Caspar Owens during his nearby campaign stop. Watch your back, Commander. This one's not going to be easy. Enemy destroyed.
By the way, my AMS is frying off. I'm going to assume that was a missile launching. Tank, sorry. And we get to walk down this way for a while. And we'll go through that cut I'm almost pointing at. We will not walk over onto the edge and fall in.
Is such a drastic show of force necessary to protect a candidate for trade president?
It's a little more complicated than that, Commander. Local democracy in the Federated Suns is a luxury granted by the various dukes and barons that administer the systems. Not
target
a basic
practice,
right,
can I say.
Like it is in the Free Worlds League. Though a majority of Federation worlds allow regional democracies to govern themselves, the Federated Suns is still, at its heart, a constitutional aristocracy.
Which means?
So, hereditary rulers can still attempt to further consolidate their own personal power over their subjects, if allowed to.
Right. Which means?
The eyes of democracy appear to be fighting against a power grab from Duke Hasek Davian. If the Duke puts his own puppet candidate in this Trade Federation position, there's no guarantee he'll ever give that power back to the people once he has it.
That wasn't the city, by the way, I just wanted to shoot it. Let's get up on this hill, maybe we can see the city. And in an assault knife.
Here we go.
Not a good idea to stand still while it's coming at you. We'll do a crossing target routine and shoot it. Since it's not available, we'll shoot this guy. Might be small, but the annoyance factor is large in that locus. Taking down some of those targets, we'll go finish this off. Scraps. Notice I got my lands forming a nice shield behind me. One of the things I commented on at the beginning of this high reward quest was that mission 4 was a significant drop in tonnage over mission 3. It's one of the few high reward quests that do that. I find it tricky. And that was a Cyclops out there, wasn't it? Yep. Can't get even a piece of it. Really don't want to go back through the medium missile or laser upgrade ordeal again. I'm just going to take a blackjack part and sell it later. Good damage by all. I mean, not astounding. Story didn't do a very good job. And kills, but he did do a good job in damage, which is normal for him. And I got that. Always nice to have. Topping off at 20.6 million C bills. Not a bad deal so far. Yep, we'll go ahead and take mission 4. Repair all. Star map, and where am I going? Where am I going? Ooh, Novaya Zemlya. I can't pronounce that the same way twice. That is going to be a place where I cannot change anything. So before I do that, pretty baby's a hot mech. Not sure if I'm going to want to take it on the next mission. I think it's like a 250, which means it would be a bit. Battlemasters at 16 days. I'm going to go ahead and take that one out of the lineup. Take a look at it and see what I can do about making it a wee bit cooler. We'll start with that. It really is about it, isn't it? I got two empty slots, but no way to consolidate them to anything I can use. Nope, might as well just put the other single back in. Hey, it's a 4 to 7.5, which is better than my usual half. I don't really want to take any of the lasers out. I mean, I could take out this medium laser, put another heat sink in, because I don't think I'm shooting it on anything. Let's find out. Nope, I got 3, so I am shooting it. Thought it was all by itself as a standalone, in which case, no, I'm not. Probably not even in a weapons group. I mean, this doesn't even have a AMS built into it, so that's about it. Not much else I can do. 80 for alpha damage is pretty impressive. 21 days. We're going to have to do that. Hey, somehow along the way, I pushed the wrong key again and stopped recording after I fixed up Pretty Baby and jumped down to Nova Gaia, whatever you got. Nova, Novaya Zemlya. And lost the entire Conspirators Part 4 mission as well, because it just wasn't recording. But now that I'm here, we're going to have to go ahead and call it an episode for the evening. Let me go do some OPA stuff. We'll get back to Conspirators Part 4 on the next episode of OPA Plays MechWarrior 5. Campaign mode modded with the Kestrel Lancer added on. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next mission. OPA out.